Hey everybody, today I'm joined by Deepa and we're going to be talking about the assessments which are built into the cloud adoption framework. So please join us. So welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we're going to be talking to Microsoft experts and tackling some of the questions and obstacles that you'll come across when you are on your cloud adoption journey. Now, as we're talking about the cloud adoption framework, we're going to be diving deeper into assessments. And assessments are questionnaires that you input information into and get some recommendations back. But to fully dive deep into this topic, I'm welcoming my guest Deepa to the show. Welcome, Deepa.
Hi, Sarah. It's great to be here.
Awesome. So as I said, we're talking about assessments. Could you tell us a bit more about assessments and why we actually have them?
Yeah, sure. So if you look at our cloud adoption framework, or even when I start looking at the customer feedback that we have gotten around the cloud adoption blockers, they really tie back to the lack of awareness and understanding of all the surrounding solutions that we have in place. So we continue to create, as you're aware, a lot of quality content that we have in our documentation, but we understand that the amount of content we have sometimes can be overwhelming for our customers. So we want to bring this guidance and this content to our customers in a way that is consumable and in a way that is actionable for them and that will help them in their journey. So we have created these assessments that are questionnaire-based, like you said, that identify where potential blockers could be for their journey, and then we provide an area of focus and recommend a place for them to start.
Awesome. Now, I must admit, the last time I looked at the assessment page, there was only one assessment. However, I think we've had additional ones added since then. So could you take us through some of what those assessments are and why we have those different ones now?
Yeah, that is correct. So when we started building out the cloud adoption framework, we started with the governance methodology. And this was because we had received feedback from our customers and also from our field that the most effective way to unblock customers is to establish a good governance foundation in their environment. So we built an assessment called the governance benchmark, which was built around the governance methodology that we have defined in the cloud adoption framework. And the main purpose of this assessment is to understand the business goals and objectives that the customer has. And by each discipline of the governance methodology, evaluate what is important for our customer and then what their current state is. At the end of this assessment, we provide a gap analysis that suggests where and how they can focus to establish that foundation that we just talked about. Since then, the cloud adoption framework has also grown. We have started to build on other methodologies within the framework, and to supplement there, we have also built additional assessments. And you can see here that we have, we have built the cloud journey tracker that spans across the strategy and the plan phase of the cloud adoption framework, a strategic migration readiness assessment that really assesses a customer's readiness to migrate to Azure. And we have the governance benchmark that we just talked about. In addition, we have two other assessments that you can find on the homepage of the assessments, on the assessments homepage, that also revolve around some other frameworks and other programs that we have.
Awesome. So it sounds like each assessment has a different purpose. Is that correct to say that they all have their kind of different purpose to help our customers on their journey?
They do. And again, to kind of take a step back, we talked about the cloud adoption framework itself and the framework, and there's a video that talks about the cloud adoption framework in much detail. But to just give you to just take a step back, the cloud adoption framework really talks about the different phases of cloud adoption. And there is no single cloud adoption path that works for every organization, but the main implement stages are similar to all organizations, which is really defining your strategy, making a plan, readying your environment and your organization, adopting the cloud, and then governing and managing your digital estate. So these assessments span across those phases. The cloud journey tracker, as I said, we recommend that the customers take this assessment at the beginning of their cloud journey, And this will help them guide through the right resource that would help them along the way. The benchmark, the governance benchmark, we talked about this. This assessment evaluates where a customer is at, with establishing a baseline in comparison to where they want to be with their governance framework. And the strategic migration and readiness tool evaluates the readiness of an organization. And this is this has questionnaire that is based on the 9 dimensions that a customer can ready their organization to move to the cloud. And with this assessment, it also helps us or understand where there are gaps in their migration readiness and how they can bridge that gap. The 4th assessment is the well-architected review. So this assessment has been built to evaluate a workload against the principles of the well-architected framework. And the 5th assessment that you can see on the platform is called the developer velocity. And that helps a customer discover the developer velocity index for their organization.
Awesome. It sounds like the assessments could actually add some value to our customers' cloud adoption journey. I'm kind of worried, though, that if they are embarking on one of these projects and they are quite time-consuming projects, why should they spend some time actually filling in these assessments? And do they actually take a really long time to fill in, or are they quite quick for them to go through?
Yeah, so why should someone spend time on an assessment? So let's take a step back and look at our customers or the ones that are either using our products or are seeking to use our products. They are responding to pressure from their customers and stakeholders to drive down cost, improve quality, or increase performance. And they're constantly looking for ways to adapt their environment, their tools and procedures to respond to their rapidly changing environment. And they do need contextual knowledge to help them with speed to deployment, understanding the highest ROI, and to also unlock the value of all these actions. But again, where will they start? And how will they find what they're looking for quickly? That's where the assessments come in. Each assessment is different, as I explained earlier, and they vary in terms of how deep you can go and how detailed they can get. The assessments do take time, but it is time really well spent. They do help the user get to curated and personalized guidance, depending on what they're looking for. So let me actually share with you an assessment here and walk you through the experience. So what you can see on my screen, Sarah, is the assessments homepage that I just talked about. So here you can see all the assessments that is available for a customer to take and a brief description on what each assessment is. So for the purpose of this demo, I will take you through the Cloud Journey Tracker. And when they land on this homepage and click on the Cloud Journey Tracker, it gives them an ability to rename the assessment, and they can change the name to whatever they want, so they can come back and refer to it later on. So once they rename name the assessment and hit next, it takes you through a series of questions, and they can go about answering these questions. And the left-hand navigation also helps them go from one question to the other. The point is that you go through all these questionnaire that we have, and at the end of the questionnaire, what they can expect is results or the overall summarization of where they are in their cloud adoption journey. In this specific instance, this is the Cloud Journey Tracker, which evaluates any potential blockers in their adoption. And it has also broken the scores down based on the various phases of the cloud adoption framework. And in this specific instance, what you can read here is there is definitely a gap in the governance methodology. So you can see the scores on the right-hand side, and right below that, the assessment provides recommendation on where to start. So based on the results, I know that I have to go in and take an assessment around the governance framework, governance methodology. And then from here on, it tells you how to bridge the gap in their governance setup. And then also you can see that the scores around the planning and the ready section is a little bit low. So it has given recommendations to say, hey, go take a look at the business value module, or go leverage the cloud, plan template that we have in place to help document what really is important and how the planning should look like. And at the bottom of the assessment, there are some other content as well that will really help them understand where they need to dig in. And you can see all these are very curated based on this specific assessment. They can share this assessment to anybody within their organization. I will not go into this right now, but if you, if anybody clicks on email, the recipient will get a link, and the link will bring them to the results page that I have shared here. So they can also look at the answer summary, which basically gives them an ability to look at all the options they had if they click on the available options and how they got to the results that they saw and what steps they need to take. So yes, so this is the, these are the assessments.
It looks like the assessments are definitely worthwhile your time going through them and getting some of the recommendations. So thank you so much, Deepa, for taking me through that today. And hopefully our audience is all sold on spending some time doing the assessments. Now, if you want to look for more information or have a go with our assessments, we're going to be posting some information in the description box below. And please tune in for future episodes of our Cloud Enablement Show.